the eighth minor prophet was named Habakkuk. Amen? Now, there's very little known about Habakkuk, but we do know that he was a prophet. And the Hebrew origin of that word, that is named Habakkuk, means to embrace. Amen? So, let's just see what the Lord wants us to know on the second Sunday of Advent, which means that we are going to celebrate the Lord's birthday soon. Amen? And Habakkuk, the second chapter and the fourth verse is going to be our focus, along with a companion scripture of John 9 and 15. Because a member called me this week and said to me that, Pastor, I was blind, but now I see. And then he closed that, and I call him a director preacher, he closed that text with, thank God for the clay. And Carolyn had just got here chastising me about eating day-old bread. And here was a situation where a man was able to see after 38 years. Did you read that in your Bible? And he was able to see because Jesus placed a laboratory, a pharmacy, a CVS,
from the Greek or the Hebrew.
Amen. And the Lord say, this is the second verse, write the vision and make it plain upon tables that he may run that readeth it. Now look over at the other translation that we have here. So that a runner can carry the correct message to others. Amen. Now look at the third verse. We're moving on. For the vision is yet for an appointed time. Habakkuk was sitting there. This is his second complaint, by the way. He must have been a part of our culture. Because he complained. He was a prophet. He was a member of the Jerusalem Baptist Church. But still, he was, I would have hated to have had him as a member. Because he was a complainer. And we got a witness. Yes. But at the end, it shall speak, and not he, though it tarry. Wait, for it will, because it will surely come, and it will not tarry. Have we got a witness? Look at the last line on that translation. Just wait on me. The last line, that's right. It will not be delayed. How many of us have wondered why God hasn't acted? Well, while you're preaching on that and think about that, look at the next verse. Look at the proud. They trust in themselves, and their lives are crooked. But the righteous will live by their faithfulness to God. Sundays to Sunday. contract with, and the person said, there's no way that you can get out of this contract except you die. And I told them, I said, I'm not thinking about that. There's always a way. And there is a way to escape the death that we will surely have if we have not accepted Jesus Christ. And then it becomes a passageway to eternal life. Amen? God is so good and so gracious. And he wants us to have joy. He wants us to be fruitful. He wants us to be free. I've got a witness. Deliver me from churches that are deader than the funeral home. I wish I had somebody. So I'm looking to see how can I walk in that door, make it a joyful moment. Preacher don't have to preach to make me joyful. I'm glad that he will. The choir doesn't have to sing to make me joyful. I'm already joyful because there are blessings.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. In the joy of Jesus. So have you considered today how you live? Because the blind man in John 9 and the 15th, 16th verse says they question the blind man. Carolyn and I, as well as Ebola and Sister Katina, we looked at the spot with our eyes as to where he lay.
All right.
At the gate.
Yes.
Now that was dirt all around, but I don't have time, that's another sermon. What I want you to see in this message, and as it relates to the whole of this lesson, is he didn't know that Peter and John were continuers of the blessings that the Lord had sent.
Right.
Have we got a witness? God had blessed David, he had blessed Moses, he had blessed Joshua, he had blessed John, and now he had blessed Peter and John as they went out. And Peter said, silver and gold, I don't have, but such as I have.
All right.
Yes, and as I said, that's another sermon. But the key connection is that when things haven't happened before, when Jesus gets into the picture, in John 9, because Jesus, as we said earlier, opened up a trust fund.
Amen.
Amen. Here's a relationship that I want you to see, and I'm going to spend 12 more minutes, and we're going to go and do something else. Amen.
Amen.
Relationship that John 9 has to this message. And that particular verse is, once he considered how long he had sat at the gate and how many people had just given him, shall we say, tokens, but had never really given him anything to heal him. Have you got words? We don't want to be satisfied as a people and as a Christian with just having life without the abundance that the Lord gives. Have you got words? I've asked you many times to pray for the pastor and deliver me from people who are satisfied, self-satisfied with how they have it. Broke as Job's turkey. That's all right. But I leave here.